What a deck!
Hello and welcome to What a Deck, where we play troll decks, rogue decks, and whatever the hell I feel like. I'm Hardleg Joe, and today we're looking at No Mill Infernoids. Now, if you're a fan of this show, you know that I don't like Infernoids. They're not my favorite archetype. Mostly because of the random nature of them. I don't like decks that have to mill a lot of cards and get lucky, essentially. I don't like reasoning as a card in general. But people have been asking me to do Infernoids, so I've made an Infernoid deck that uses no milling whatsoever. Or rather, it mills, but I choose everything that gets milled. It doesn't have any random effects to it. And it works pretty decently. So if you're just looking for the deck profile, I've got a link in the description. You can check that out. I'll just explain everything that's in here and why it's in here. Otherwise, I'm going to be playing this in 10 duels against random opponents on YGOPro, and we're just going to see how it does, see how it works. So I'll see you in the first duel. Okay, here we are in the first duel versus Hype, which is either really friendly or Japanese. I can't tell. I assume we'll find out if I can ever pick a rock, but there we go. You want to go second in this deck? This is a very reactionary deck. It's kind of a toolbox, kind of a... what's the word for it? I cannot think of the word for it. Card advantage sort of deck. We're playing against Magic Spectres, not the best matchup because they cannot be destroyed by card effects. However, I can destroy all their back row, which may or may not... No, I can't target them. Well, fuck. Isn't that just fantastical? Oh, and he's got so many things already. Eh, but he's got no extra deck, so... At least he doesn't synchro fusion. During the end phase, add one Magic Spectre card from your... Okay. I think I'd be more familiar with these, but I am not. I didn't really play much against them. At least we got two of those, so that'll give us some abilities. Let's see. It's a pity we can't summon this guy out. This guy requires three. He'll destroy all spell traps my opponent controls. For now, we're just going to get our Frozen Void. And we're going to send this guy to the graveyard. This will let us search out any of our void cards. And I think I'm going to pick this, because I don't want to be targeted by shit. Because he targets a lot of stuff, and this will prevent most of my guys. So then I'm going to go ahead and summon him from the graveyard by banishing two of these. Sad to see them go, but it's fine. I've got more attack, and if I inflict battle damage to him, I can discard a card from his hand, so I can start getting that card advantage up, unless he negates my summon, son of a bitch. It's okay. He obviously, well, I guess he might have his scales now, he's got four whole cards, but I've got two of these. I think I can launch both of them. This will let me send two Infernoid monsters from my deck to the graveyard during my standby phase, so I can fill it with a whole bunch of stuff. And hopefully make the thing that I really want to make, which is, again, Net Decker. I don't know his actual name. Deveda, Data Plan. That's what I've been calling him Data Plan. I don't know how to pronounce that. Deviatiati something? I don't know. I like Lilith better. I wish they'd kept the theme of having all these sort of, biblical names and everything. But, you know, it's the children's card games. You can't call things like Asmodeus and Beelzebub and Lilith. You've got to give them weird names. Apparently these are like numbers in other languages and stuff like that. If I recall. I looked these up. Yeah, we'll just be back when it's my turn. Okay, here we go. First of all, can we summon all, or can we activate both of these? I think we can. Yes! Just big old long chain. So we're going to send that, and this guy with that one. And likewise, well, we want to keep one in the deck. So we're going to send, but this guy we don't really need. Same with this, is not going to be useful because we can't target or can't target them with effects. Or blow them up with this guy. This guy destroys all... If you're unfamiliar with Infernoids, this guy, when he's summoned, destroys all monsters. This destroys all spell traps. So that's what we really need to do, is get all those spell traps out of the way. So let's just do one of those. And hope he cannot negate my summon. Nope. Obviously, he'll destroy this by tributing one of his things, but the effect will still go off. Which means his pendulum scale, all those... Oh, wait, no! I can make him immune! Immune to all card effects! Ha ha, hee hee ho ho. Unless, oh, he's probably got another one, actually. Now that I'm thinking of it. There you go. That gives me a distinct advantage now, doesn't it? And no, I won't activate that. Not that effect. This, in addition to being able to search for things, which I will go ahead and search for things, I'm gonna get another one of these, because very useful. If they battle one of my monsters, one of my Infernoid monsters, I can banish both of them by sending this card to the graveyard. Which right now I don't really want to do if he... Yeah, unless he gets something from the extra deck, but again, his extra deck is so small. So small. Let's hope that he cannot pendulum, because otherwise... Fuck, he can pendulum. He's going to get all his things back. Do I have another one of these in the graveyard? I think I do. Set one, but he can't activate it. No, I do not. But it's okay, I'll get to send four more cards, so I can do this again. It's just a matter of can he negate my things. Because I'd rather not have my things negated. Okay, there's that again. And I've got another one of these, so he's not going to be able to do much of anything. Well, at least with that. We'll see. He's got some stuff. He's going to summon things. That'll let him add a spell card. But he can only use... Okay, so he'll get one spell card, one trap card, and one card. But he won't be able to use that one because it's end phase. Oh, I can negate their effects. But do I want to? Yeah, because the trap card is the only thing I'm afraid of. The spells are not really going to affect me. And plus, he's only going to hit me for 1,300. Plus, that banishes him, so he can't get it back. He's just going to get one spell card, and he can add another one during his end phase. Granted, I'm going to be taking some damage, but he put everything in defense mode, luckily. So it's not going to be too bad. I'll take 23 at the most, assuming he uses that in the damage step. And then I'll be able to summon my thing, and if he uses his Magispector Cyclone, I can just Void Sear it again. Blow up his scales once more, and this time I know he won't be able to rebuild them. And then just slowly attack all his things. Oh, maybe he can rebuild them, actually, if he's getting another thing. Fuck. Damn pendulums. Pendulums actually aren't that bad in this deck, or against the Infernoids. It's just a matter of, like, because these guys also can't be destroyed, I can't swarm the field like I usually do. So yeah, let's just send... Which one destroys monsters? This one and this one? Because they are not going to be useful to me. The little ones that only require one banish, you can send them from the hand. So I want to put them in the graveyard. I don't want to have them in my hand. Let's try... And that guy. There we go. We're going to go ahead and use our Decatron while we're at it. Because Decatron, what he can do is when he's summoned, he's the only one you can normal summon. All the other Infernoids, you have to banish Infernoids from your hand or graveyard. I guess I should have started with that. These have been out a while, so I assumed everyone kind of knew what they were doing. That's fine. Yeah, I mean, that's fine. That's just going to put more resources. I'll still get the effect. Wait, avoid destruction? Oh, it destroys it, yeah. So Void Seer you can banish from the graveyard to stop one of your monsters from being destroyed. But anyway, as I said, he can send one Infernoid to the graveyard and he gains its effect. So I'll go ahead and use it. This one's effect is once per turn you can blow up one spell trap your opponent controls. So I'll make sure he can't use that. And then I'll just special summon this dang old guy back out, using the three things I sent before. Oh, whoops. Fuck. I messed that up. I shouldn't have set this. I don't know why I did. Oh, it was for last turn. Yeah, let's just go ahead and make him unaffected by stuff. That's a pity. Yeah, he'll blow up all cards on the field unless they're void cards. And even though this is a void card, it's face down, so it doesn't count. And we're going to kill this, if we have to kill anything. Oh, I could do that. Oh, this can't attack the same turn, yeah. Okay, we're good. We're good, we still got some stuff. This guy, in addition to blowing up all the spell traps, if your opponent activates a monster effect, you contribute another Infernoid to negate and destroy it. Negate and banish it. Sorry. Yeah, we'll just continue to send things. Pretty sure we're good on that regard. Unless he activates some stuff. I mean, he's got all these set spell traps. Yeah, that targets... And I think at that point, we don't want to send any more stuff, because we don't have enough stuff to send. Plus, we want to use this guy. We'll use his effect again, unless he negates it. And we're just going to do the same thing we did before. We're just going to make him the guy who blows up spell traps. Because once per turn, we can just blow up his spell traps. There's a one. Use the other one. A tahoo! Okay, he's gonna negate it. That's fine. Oh, I can avoid destruction from a counter trap? Huh. I did not know that. How very strange. Oh, and because his effect was negated, he could still... Okay. So I can attack into that. And we'll go ahead and use this to banish, so he doesn't get that. And then I can attack directly for 2,900. And from here, I'm pretty set, because if he activates a monster effect, I can use his effect to negate it by tributing this Decatron over here. So he's not going to be able to grab his stuff. And because it doesn't destroy, it negates and banishes. It is, fucking Magispectors won't be able to stop it. So it was a long journey, but that's how this deck works. It just keeps blowing up their things. And yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and just send the rest of my stuff to the graveyard, because at the moment all I want is all the other stuff that's still in the deck. We'll attack that. Sure, extra 500. Because one of the other effects that most of the little Infernoids have, they contribute themselves or any other Infernoid to banish a card from your opponent's graveyard. So if he's going to attack this with something big, I can just like negate and I can get rid of him so that I won't take a shit ton of damage. Of course, he's got his pendulum scales again, and he's got all these things. He's just going to be summoning them like crazy. So maybe we're doomed after all. Unfortunately, the only one I'd be able to stop is Cat. And... Cat's not really... I mean, he can grab a card. At this point, I've committed to the field. There's not much I can do. He's already used a lot of his spell traps. If I could negate Crow, I would, because again, I'm afraid of that trap. This, he can set something, but he can't use it this turn. Either way, he's all in defense mode, so I'm not taking any damage this turn. I'll just be back next turn. Well, I guess I'll let you see what he gets. Sonic, which is again going to double his attack, but he didn't have anything that can get over 29. And shuffle it into the deck, which I can just... Yeah. If he wants to use that, that's fine, because I can just literally... Void launch it back into my graveyard. Yeah, I mean, that's fine. Go ahead. I'll void launch it. I'll use this to blow up his pendulum scale. He'll grab something else, though. See how it all works out. I'll be back in a second. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and activate our Void Purgatory. Purgatiro. And we'll just send that to the graveyard, so we can use it again. This doesn't really worry me. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to activate Frozen Void again. Because there's nothing he can do about that. I'm going to discard this so I can blow up his Pendulum Scale. Because this can only do a set card unless it's in the graveyard. So we'll just go ahead, send that to the graveyard, and I'll search. I'll get something cool. Something cool, man. I guess this is the only thing I can grab, really, which is not going to be too useful at the moment. If he had extra deck cards, it would be more useful. So, we blow up that with this guy. We blow up the other one with our Galaxy Cyclone. And then we summon back another big old dang old beat sticky kind of thing. Oh, I can't use... Okay. Well, that's fine. We'll just get this again. So Decatron's not useful from the graveyard. Neither is that or that. But that's okay. We've got Galaxy Cyclone in the graveyard now. Yeah, this will actually make all my Infernoids level 1. One of the big flaws with the Infernoids, you can't summon them if you have, what was it? If there are levels of the effect monsters you control are 8, they have to be 8 or lower. So if you summon this 9, you can't summon anything else. Same thing, there's the 10, the big guy. You can only summon one of them, you can't have both of them out. Unless you have this, this makes them all level 1. Which is pretty useful. Let's see. And I am going to... I'll kill his frog, because that's the least useful. And... Oh, I can't attack. Yep, I forgot about that. But yeah, this makes them all level 1, but they also do deal half damage. And because it's not really beneficial to swarm as much, as long as I can keep him from doing things, yes. We will negate and banish. Haha! There goes your normal summon, bro. So yeah, this isn't this. I can also send this to the graveyard to fusion summon, which I have a really strong fusion summon monster, and it lets me use monsters from my deck as fusion material. But he has to control a monster summon from the extra deck, and he does not. So I'm just gonna get rid of that, and we'll get another one of these, just because I want a deck thin, so I can hopefully get to my whatchamacallit. What can I use from here? Oh, I'll just blow up my own stuff. Yeah, I don't need to do that. I'll just kill his kitty. Meow. What's it called? Necroface. Necroface will let me shuffle all the banished cards back into the deck. So I'll have another really high beat stick, and also I won't have to worry about, decking out. I can reuse some of these cards. I can resummon things. What's he gonna summon? He's running out of cards, too. This is a long-ass duel. So, you know what? I'm gonna start skipping again. I'm gonna skip. We'll be back when interesting stuff happens. Oh. Well, interesting stuff is happening right now, because if he thinks he's getting that effect, he is dead wrong. Because I can just summon this... It's better for me to tribute this and get it off the field, because I'll just summon it again and get rid of his field spell. Yeah, it's not very fun when someone negates everything you do. Isn't it, Magispectors? That's not very useful. Deck thinning, the movie, the game. So many void dreams. Yeah, either way, I've won this. I've got this. Let's just get rid of those again. Bada bingo. Blow up your dang old field spell. And 29 for the win! So we got our first win, it took a long time. But we beat Magispectors. So we go into the next duel, maybe we'll fight goodbye. And hey, here we are in the second duel versus Macross. Maybe some kind of banish deck, which may or may not do good against me. We're gonna go second again. I guess I should point out I got my sleeves that got Data Plan and the Pain Train here. A new coup. He started as a Nuku, and I was just like, I'm just gonna call him Choo Choo. And then he became the Pain Train, because there's a lot of decks who do not like something you can summon every turn that Oh. What is it? Oh! Oh, I got a mirror match. We'll see. It depends how good his, yep. I may have lost. It's one of the reasons I don't like Infernoids, because they can pretty much just, like I said, it's completely random. If he happened to get his one monster gate, and his Decatron happened to be farther down in the deck, so he got to mill a whole bunch of stuff. Most of the time, it doesn't work out like that. Let's see, he got that so he can negate my monster's effects, which is no good. But that's fine, we've got stuff we can do. I'm just going to send my choo-choo. I'll get a Decatron of my own. And I'll use his effect and force him to negate it or be destroyed. Yep. Oh, I could stop him. I think I will. Take that! Ha ha ho 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 ho! Let's see. What do I want to send? Probably this guy, because then we'll get in a negation war. Negation war! And... oh, I can't... ah, fuck. Well, whatever. 500. Yep, I think I've lost. I've already lost. Just because I messed that up. I should have let him be destroyed, then I could have summoned this. But I tried to make him not affected by things. Now he's going to be able to summon a whole... oh wait, no, he can't summon a whole bunch of stuff. But he's going to be able to summon at least two things. And then I will be in trouble. Especially this thing, it can attack once again a row. And it's level... yeah, 8 or lower, so he could summon this and then something else. Probably the thing that blows up all the things. It's weird how the one weakness I have is the mirror match. Why would you summon that? Do you not have a Nuku? You have an Anuku. Seems like the better choice. Because that's gonna... oh wait, he's just not gonna activate the effect. Okay. Just more attack, I guess. I think I've already lost this. Yep. We'll be back. Oh no. Ah, oh, he's got the void imagination. The void dream, as it used to be called. That's no good. That's no good at all. Yeah, I mean, it might as well. Just make sure he can't use that effect. No more things in the graveyard. It's a pity I got the... oh, and he's got his void seer. The tables have turned. Of course, he deals half damage, and now he can't attack twice. So I'll have another turn to do things. Oh, no, he's not. Because he sent the guy that destroys spell traps. So now I've lost. GG. GG. Alright, here we are. Second duel versus... Mean Miss Jeff? I'm just gonna call you Jeff. I think Jeff seems like a good name. We've got a... okay starting hand. We don't have any of our really cool spell traps. Not gonna be able to do a whole lot of damage. Fortunately, we just play these two necro faces, and they're one of those... you gotta have some sort of recovery to get your banished monsters either back into the deck or back into the graveyard. I was running, I think it was called Miracle Dig for a while, but at least this has some utility. Miracle Dig is just useless 90% of the time. He is going first. I don't know what he's doing. Oh, there's a... oh, pardon me. I'm burp-tastic today. Just burp-palooza. Let's see what he's got here. Set cards. And that's all he did. Okay. No, that's fine. Okay. Yep, we're gonna want to blow stuff up. So we're gonna start off with our good old Decatron. And we're gonna send the guy that destroys spell traps. And destroy one of his spell traps. The big old spell trap brigade. Although, granted, I could just summon this. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna send this guy instead. Because, one, now he's in the graveyard. And I control level 11. Okay. Yeah, it's when he's summoned. I'm dumb. I keep forgetting that. This damn level mechanic ain't good. But at least if he activates some kind of spell trap, I can negate it. Because obviously he's running heavy on the spell traps right now. This will let us special summon an Infernoid from our hand, ignoring its summoning conditions. Good. That's gone. And now he's in the graveyard. And now I can summon this from my hand, and if it gets destroyed, it'll be in the graveyard, and I'll have more options. And he won't be able to get past 29, not too easily. I can put it in defense mode, too, if it looks like he's running some sort of rank 4 spam or something. Hey, what do you know? Some kind of rank 4 spam or something. And of course, this is chainable at any time. So, you know, we're just going to see what he does, and then I'll be back. Okay, he's just going to attack for 1,700. And I'm inclined to just let him do that, because that's not that bad. If I summon out something, he can make Castell or 101 and get rid of this, and I don't want that. Nobody wants that. Now I got this, though. So I think what I'm going to do is try to get the hand advantage down. This guy will make him discard. I'm not really worried so much about that. So we're going to try that. This is... Yep. Special summon. I'm going to get from... Hand and hand. Or hand and graveyard. Ha-ha! Ho-ho! I attack your old hair, good sir! And this one takes two. There's basically... There's a bunch of small, like, if they're level 4 or low... Ooh! Air Force. Yeah, we'll go ahead and use this. Just to waste his things. I am unaffected. I will kill you unless you have honest. Which honestly is to be expected. Oh, he does have honest. Well, fuck you too then. Can I summon things? I could summon him back. Yeah, let's wait one more turn. We can always block with this. And then we can necroface. Unless he makes Tiver. But he doesn't seem like the kind of guy who wants to make Tiver. Seems like he wants to do other things. He's got other prerogatives with his life. There's the ukulele. Ukulakaligula, whatever it's called. Yeah. Once again, he seems to take a while to think, so we'll be... Oh, Soul Charge. Oh, are you trying to build that big, huge thing? It's like 4 monsters or something? Or 4 more warriors? We're not going to be able to attack this turn, so I don't really need to worry about that. Oh yeah, okay, that's what I was explaining. So there's little level 4 or lower Infernoids, you have to banish 1. The 5 or 6 ones, you have to banish 2. And then the 9 and 10 require 3 banishes. It's almost like tributing monsters, just instead of tributing them, you banish them from your hand or graveyard. So there's that. This is what, like a half an hour in? You're finally learning how the basic of Infernoids? Ugh, I get distracted too easily. It's these sleeves, I think. They're really weird looking. It's a lot of different colors. Why are you making Tiver? I don't want him to discard my Necroface. But I also don't want to take 3,100. So fuck it. Necroface, go bye-bye. Well, at least I got something to block me from taking all the damage. Oh, it just comes back anyway. Okay, so all that did was waste my resources. Fantastic. Please don't take my Necroface. Take this, damn it. I hate the world. I'm hating such a good time. I'm hating a ball. At least I got this. Aha! Fuck your face down card. No torrential tribute for you, my good sir. Let's just try this again. Because I've got 100 more. And then I'll discard from your hand. And I believe he gets to summon one from the deck or something? No, one in his graveyard. Oh, and I can't interrupt. Okay, it's and then. Can I activate his effect? No. I can't activate his effect in the damage step. It would seem. Otherwise, I could stop this chain of events from taking place. It's kind of bullshit, actually. Yeah, I should be able to tribute my monster and banish his Altair before this can summon it. Unless I can't activate. Doesn't say I can't. Doesn't say except the battle phase. Weird. Well, whatever. There's our second loss. But I won't make you wait. This is already going on really long. These are super long duels. And here we are in the fourth duel versus Galaxy. Will he play Galaxy cards? I've got a Galaxy card. I've also got Void Dream and Void Launch, which are both really good cards to have. Maldoche is almost the opposite of Galaxy. You're not very space-themed. Well, I guess that's kind of... It's candy space. It's yeah, they're in weird, some sort of weird candy space. I don't think they can do much. I mean, it's fucking Maldoche's. I actually tried to make a Maldoche deck for one of the bigger subscribers, McButts. They're like one of his favorite ones. But try as I might, pretty much every variation I could make was, like, the only variation that worked was just this turbo one that used a bunch of stuff. And it wasn't particularly awesome or anything. So I had to give it up. My apologies to him. Why would you set Raigeki just to, as bait? Okay. Well, anyway, now I could show off this whole Void Dream thing because it controls an extra deck monster. So what I'm going to do, activate this. And I'll send it to the graveyard. To fusion summon Infernoid Terra. So I can use... I have to use Choo Choo and Data Plan. I'll use the one from my hand, because it doesn't need to be in my hand. One from my deck. And then I can use six other materials from my deck. And we're basically just going to send one each of those again. I'm going to send one of these guys, because he can be used from the graveyard. And, let's see. Probably... You want to pick ones with different names. Yeah, the one that destroys a monster, and one of these guys. And, well, I could use stuff in my hand, too. Nah, I'm good. I will not choose material from my hand. So we'll summon him. When he's summoned, we each send three cards from our extra deck to the graveyard. I'm going to pick Tierra, I'm going to pick Omega, so I can shuffle things back into the graveyard if I need to, and I'm going to pick Kendama, because if I control no cards, I can special summon him as a defense. And then he gets to send three. Oh, and we also mill... I did five or more, so we send the top three cards. We mill five. Not something I want to do, but, you know, whatever. It happens sometimes. And obviously, if I could do eight, I could put banished cards back into my graveyard. But I cannot do such a thing. Yeah, from there, I'm good. Chateau, no. Okay, so my milling helped. It helped. It got rid of his stuff, too. So I'll just attack that. 3,400. And so this guy, 3,400 is nothing to laugh at to begin with. He doesn't really have any effect other than that, and that he makes them thin out their extra deck. The main thing is I just got six cards in my extra deck, and I got to choose which ones I wanted. So I got to make sure that I have an Anuchu and a Data Plan in there. So whatever he happens to get, I'll be able to summon out. Like, even if he makes Tiramisu and shuffles both of these back into the deck, I'll be able to summon something and destroy all spells or all traps and just completely ruin his day. And that's the crux of this deck, essentially, is just getting one of those two in the graveyard and then using either monsters or spells, or if you're lucky enough to get the Void Imagination, you could do both, as long as you do them in the proper order, and just blow up his stuff. And until then, you just got these little guys, which, I mean, once per turn I can blow up a monster, so if he makes something, I can do stuff. Fortunately, he messed this up. Why are you attacking that? You just lose all hope? Just want to shuffle things back into the deck? And normally what they do is they banish one of their Maldoches, and then they use, what was it called? The Levier to summon the banished card, but for some reason he banished this guy instead. And like I said, that's why I don't, all the Maldoche decks that I could make, that I could come up with, the best Maldoche deck, Madolche, is essentially just like, this thing that shuffles around and makes Synchros until, or makes Ixie monsters until you get Tiramisu. And Tiramisu's not that great. Either way, We get our fourth win. We're tied up. Going in the fifth duel. Okay, fifth duel versus Marino. Not quite Mario, not quite a Marina. Just Marino. We got a decent hand. We got our Decatron, so we can get our data plan in the graveyard. We've got our Anuchu already. We've got this guy if we need him. And we've got our Void Launch, which if it doesn't get MST'd is going to be... Oh, it's these guys. These pendulums. It's a sad state of affairs. Because they can blow up something once per turn. So this thing that's awesome that lets you send two Infernoids each turn, not going to be useful. We pretty much need imagination at this point. And we've got the guy that can blow up one monster, which is not going to be too effective against these. Really, the guy that destroys a spell trap, much more useful. Oh, and he's playing the Apex Avian version. Well, that might actually work out. Because I can summon multiple... No, that'll work perfectly, because I can blow up... I'll get Decatron. He'll destroy it. Are you making fucking Cyber Infinity Dragon, you piece of trash? I hate you. You are trash, and I hate you. Oh, wait, no, he can't do it this turn. So let's see. Whenever an effect is activated... So you can negate one thing. I'm going to say if you want to negate something, negate this, because I could still use it from the graveyard. There you go. If it's negated, can I use its effect? I don't think so. Because it's not the same turn it was sent. And then we'll... Wait, I gotta think this through. Okay. Yeah, special summon this guy first. In attack mode. Probably should have been defense, but I want to make sure he can't destroy all the things. I'll blow up this. Summon Decatron. Make the thing that can blow up spells. So there's your Ptolemaeus. He could summon something on top of it, but it's not going to be able to activate its effect before it gets destroyed. Oh, wait, no, the target will be different. You garbage. Human garbage. That's fine. I'll just have to change this up a little bit. That's it. I'll just have to change things up. It's all right. Just a little waterlogged. It's fine. Solemn Scolding. Oh, it has to be the only set card. That is a hefty price, and let's see, he can discard one card, one pendulum monster. Yeah, I'll just set this. Hopefully he doesn't, that's Apex Avian, he's gonna get Cyber Infinity Dragon, like the human garbage he is, and absorb this. I cannot wait until they ban Ptolemaeus. I just cannot wait. You are not getting more material from me, good sir. I will banish your fucking... this thing. And you can negate it, but I'll be destroyed. So, either way, you're not getting that. There we go. And then the helpful thing is that during the standby phase, I'll activate this, and he'll negate it with this or Avian, and then I can special summon this guy and just attack over his things. If I don't die right here. No, I won't die right here. I'll just take a lot of damage, and I won't like it. But I won't die. Let's go and... Oh, wait, no. Yeah, I want to activate as many things at the same time as possible so that he has to choose. Choose wisely, my friend. Choose wisely. Okay, standby phase. Activate this. See if he negates. Activate the effect. He will probably negate, unless he doesn't negate. Either way, that's fine. I don't mind. There you go. Oh no, not that. Too bad you can't negate the summon of this guy. Granted, I'm going all in. I've got no resources at this point. Don't use his effect because Avian can destroy it. But I can get over his Cyber Dragon Infinity. Avian can't do shit to me now that I'm already here with 3,000. So I'm good. I'm good. What do I have in the graveyard that I can... Oh, yeah. Oh, why didn't I... No! Oh, oh, he could have negated... No. Yeah, he could have negated it anyway. It's fine. It's fine. Ah, he got another level 4. That piece of trash. Ugh, Cyber Dragon Infinity. Got me steamed every time, all the time. Such garbage. Well... That's that. Okay, 6 duel versus player. My old nemesis. I almost said my own name. That would have been silly. I am the Noid, of course, because all these things are voids, and you must avoid the Noid, which is a pizza thing from the 80s, I believe. I don't know. Having trouble coming up with puns on some of these newer decks. It was either that or name myself like Beelzebub or Satan or something like that, but I'm good. I'm good on that. Let's see, Tariff, okay, Chicken Race. It could be a whole bunch of different stuff. Some sort of OTK deck, maybe, or just a really fast, non-OTK kind of deck. We'll see, we've got our Foolish Burial. If he makes a Synchro Monster, he could do that. Are you playing Gishkis? That's an interesting choice. I won't be able to use this against Ritual Monsters. It's a sad state of affairs. Alright, that works. Let me just get me my card. Thank you. Excellent. We will foolishly burial some things. I think we just want to take Choo Choo. Get him out of there. Okay. Void Seer. Activate. Get rid of that. And get us... one of these, because I can't imagine he has much spell trap removal. Then we'll special summon one of this guy. I gotta do all 3. Okay. And yes, I will use Data Plan's market effect. Get rid of that, so you're taking some damage. Do said damage. Unless he's got something, I don't know what he could act. Trick Clown, interesting. Either way, he's gonna die. I don't want to banish that. We're good. And then we'll set that, and we'll activate this just to be bait, essentially. We'll see what he does. If he has MST, hopefully he won't use it on this. He'll use it on one of these two. Okay, good. Another Chicken Race. Fantastic. Of course, I can negate his effect. So if he does summon some kind of Zeal Gigas, I can stop it from shuffling things. I'll let him, again, my, this isn't a threat to me. Zeal Gigas is a threat to me. Some kind of Ixie monster is a threat to me. I will let him do the things he wants to do, and then once he uses up all his cards doing so, then I will negate that effect. And yeah, I'll take 1800 or whatever, but Chicken Race is still up on the field, so once I do, I won't be taking a crap ton. Okay, he's doing he's gonna make an Ixie monster and Zeal Gigas. It's the worst of both worlds. I'll be taking 3200, probably. It depends what kind of Ixie monster he makes. But I already know he has the ritual, and he has one of the things that he can use to use for the ritual. So it's really just a matter of if he has that monster in his hand. Yep, he's gonna try for that Dark Rebellion. See, that can stop me. So I am not going to allow that to happen. I am going to destroy. Arg. Yep, there's the Zeal Gigas. He's coming, guys. Oh, he's got so much. So I'll be taking 3200 straight to the face. It's going to be terrible, but I'll be able to get rid of this next turn. I'll be able to get rid of it so hard. Really my only hope is that he can't... Well, even if he summons two, his own Chicken Race is gonna... Oh, you got rid of my face down. No. That was the one I needed. Why not get rid of one of these? Hobo. You know these are threats. Now I gotta hope. Okay, I got one. Yeah, but literally any of the ones that I get are going to be useful to me. Except for the one that destroys spell traps. That might not be useful to me. So we'll see. We'll see. It depends what I draw. Alright, he summoned another Zeogigas. Oh, Raigeki. Ah, great, now he has Raigeki. At least he doesn't get to shuffle things into my graveyard. Or into my deck. Well, unless he has the tools to summon another one. Great, my favorite. Let's just draw one card. Let's see. Well, he's already got that. He's already got that. Let's see. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to Frozen Void, get rid of Galaxy Cyclone, for Void Seer. I am going to... Why can I activate one for... Oh, it has to be a monster from my hand to the graveyard. Fuck, I thought it was any card. Well, in that case, I'm just downright lost against fucking Gishkis. Fantastic. Next duel. And here we are in the seventh duel versus Magic, my old nemesis, my new nemesis. These card games are trying to go against each other. We're versus some not-so-good deck. Oh, it's our good old friends from last week, Dino Mist, with no extra deck. Unless he's just doing the Cyber Dragon Infinity variant, which is very well likely. Should have... I'm very highly reconsidering this one for one, given how few monsters I have in this deck. I mean, I have more monsters than traps, but it's not all monsters, and... Already, this is proving to be my downfall. He's got his Ceratops, and that's his field. Alright. Neat. Let's go ahead and get our Decatron. Dodecahedron. We're gonna put it in defense mode. Because we're just gonna use this dang old effect. We're going to send... Where's the spell trap? This guy's a spell trap. Let's go ahead and not let you get any of your extra deck monsters. And then... We'll... I guess set this just as a backup. And I'll keep that for now. For now! But soon, my friend, soon. Then you'll see. You'll all see! I have no idea what I'm talking about. Oh, he's got Dino Miss Brachion. He's got a whole lot of stuff. There's not much I can do about that. I mean, I get a thing. End of the battle phase. Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. I got this. Galaxy Cyclone. Get rid of that. Whatever it is. Probably Dino Mist Rush. Probably Dino Mist Rush. If you want to chain that, that would be nice. You can go ahead and do that. It's hunky dory with me. There we go. Dino Mist Rush. Which means it's going to be unaffected by stuff till the end phase. Oh, Tyrannosaur. That's going to go into his extra deck. We're just going to go ahead and get our Anutu. Our Choo Choo Train. Destroy all the other things, i.e. his Brachion. And then attack this by battles for a little extra damage. For a little damage. And there we go. We just gotta hope he can't complete his scales right this moment. Otherwise, we may be doomed. No, he cannot create his scales right this moment. We are not doomed. And I can go ahead and just use my Galaxy Cyclone to make sure he has nothing. Absolutely nothing. Hit him with the old 3K. Bada bingo. And then... Well, either way, he's pretty much dead. Because he can't activate a spell trap, which means I'm not going to let him pendulum summon. If he tries to get his other pendulum out, I just blow it up with Nehemoth. And then during the end phase, I can special summon Lilith. Or I can... Yeah, I'll just special summon Lilith. Oh! Ah! Well, fuck it. I mean, I can't use its effect, but I can go ahead and... I guess I don't really need its effect at this point. Point is, you're dead. Good game. That was really fast. Next duel. Whoa, that's a weird name. It's like OT, but the T's like a little weird and got fuzzy. I'm gonna go second again. I guess I should mention, it's pretty far to mention. If you want the sleeves, Patreon. I mention that every time, but people keep forgetting, or they don't know, or new people keep coming. But if you want these sleeves, if you donate $1 to Patreon, you will get these sleeves, plus all the sleeves I've ever made for all the Wada decks. We're playing Magical Mallet. He's got no... I gotta assume this is some kind of Exodia deck. Because Monarchs have enough draw power, they would not play Magical Mallet. And nothing else doesn't play an extra deck. Let's see. This can destroy one monster on the field. Yeah. So, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to banish this one. Get this guy out. And I'm just going to blow up your thing because it might have an effect where it's destroyed by battle. No, it's just Royal Magical Library. Okay. Yep. Probably would have been good. Yeah, we're good with that. I can't attack the same turn I use that effect. This guy would probably have been better if I'd known. Because if I destroy him by battle, I can make him discard a random card. He's just getting all these things. Fortunately, he doesn't seem to have all the spell cards that he wants. Well, he might. I don't know. Either way, I'm not going to make you sit through this, so we'll see. Either way, if I get another Infernoid next turn, if I can blow this up, I can make him discard a piece of Exodia, and I don't think he has the stuff to... Well, actually, I don't know if this will work, but let's go ahead and try it. I'm going to banish his White Stone of Legend and see if that stops it from activating because it's no longer in the grid. Nope. Doesn't have to remain there. At least we know. It's not like I'm going to be attacked or anything. What? He just surrendered. Oh, okay. Win with an asterisk next to it. Yeah. And here we are versus another player. My old nemesis come back to return, I assume. Get himself a rematch. Do 40 card. Okay, he's got a 40 card deck. We're going second, which is no good. I don't really have anything, but I don't want to risk it. So what we're going to do, we're going to play this. We're going to send our Galaxy Cyclone to the graveyard. And we are going to get this thing. Because this will help set up our maneuvers. And then we are going to put up a defense. Hoo hoo. And then we're going to set this. And we're just going to hope that he can't both kill this and this. Because otherwise, we're pretty doomed. Although, if he kills both these, but he summons an extra deck monster, we can use Void Dream to get Terra Firma. So we'll see. He's got Shaddolls. It could literally be... Oh, he's playing some sort of weird new... Whoa! Not seen this one. If this card is sent to the... Okay. Neither player can special summon from the hand or graveyard with spell trap effects. That is fine. I'm not doing that at all. I'm special summoning from the hand or graveyard with monster effects. So that's not going to affect me really at all whatsoever. Is he going to get Norden? I think he's going to get Norden. I don't want him to get Norden. Norden's going to be a bad time. Oops. Come on, don't make me put all these asterisks. I have to do extra duels or some shit. Hey, here we are in the 10th duel, but probably not the final duel versus Yo. We had Hi earlier as another greeting. Doing a more than 40 card deck. We're going first, which is never good. And, I don't really... Well, yeah, we'll go ahead. We're just going to set out our defense wall. Defense! Ho, ho, ho. This guy can also send a card back to the hand, which is good against Ixie Synchro decks and stuff like that. But I'm just going to put that out there, because we got Void Seer, so we can prevent it from being destroyed, we can prevent it from being targeted. And it's another... Hopefully we can keep this. If we can keep this for one turn, then we can start making plays, because we're going to have stuff in the graveyard. really just matters what he does and what we draw next. Ooh, Yang Zings. This is going to be a toughie. Because I got this card that with my Choo Choo that's just going to blow up cards every single turn. He's not going to be able to do stuff, or I'm not going to be able to do as much to him. Fortunately, I do have some options. I have a couple options. You will see my options soon enough. Oh, what does this do? Once per turn, if a monster you control is destroyed by Batic, special summon Yang Zing. Okay. Fortunately, I think I've got the remedy right here with this guy. Plus this. So we're going to just send... I don't want to destroy... This destroys monsters, right? Yeah, I don't want to do that. I'm going to send those. There you go. And then I'm going to special summon. Using these two. This guy. Which, I have to attack a monster to make him discard, which I can't do. But that's fine. What I can do is send this back to his hand. And just hit him for 2200. Just straight off the bat. And hopefully I'll be able to do that every turn. Of course, now that I have an attack position monster, he can ram his stuff into me if he's smart and just start summoning mass amounts of things. Which may be... Well, I can tribute him to banish a card from his graveyard, so I might be able to do some stuff after all. And like I said, of course, I can shut him down, but then we'll be a kind of a stalemate again. Or I'll just let him summon things. If he wants to ram and take damage, because he's already at a little bit of his disadvantage, he'll have to take some damage in order to get out so that he can synchro. And then once he does, I can Void Dream and make Terra and keep it safe with Apostle. Or Void Seer, rather. Man, Apostle of Purgatory just sounds so much cooler than Void Seer. This makes me think of searing a grill. And he surrendered. Well, we have won more to surrenders than fucking anything. I'm going to do at least one more, maybe two. I'm hesitant to be like, let's just do two more duels, because what if it lasts a half hour? But assuming they don't last a half an hour, we're going to go to 12 today. Oh yeah. Okay, here we are in the 11th bonus duel versus Smiley Face with a bracket. How very appropriate. I'm glad that I stayed for this. Let's just hope he is friendly with his 60-card deck and his 14... Wait, my extra deck is 14 cards? How did that happen? Has it been that... Oh, I'm sad now. Okay, we're good. I'm just gonna set that. That's the bad thing about these, is that you can't really have a field presence unless you've got the big ones. Your opening hand kind of sucks. You need a little bit to prepare. Okay, he's playing Lightsworn, so that's why his deck is so big. He's going to be milling like crazy. It looks like he's got some Clown Blade stuff thrown in there, too. I could summon a defense if I need one, but it's probably not going to need one. Make that. Destroy this. I'll summon something out. He'll destroy it with Michael. It'll be a win-win. Let's just go ahead and... Let's see. Spell traps we're probably not going to be worrying about. So let's get this. And hopefully he won't banish it. He might banish it, but let's hope that he does not. Oh, what do you know? He did not banish it for some reason. I would have thought for sure he would summon Michael. And shenanigans would go down. It'd be a shenana-banana-rama. But no, he's just milling. He just wants to mill all these things. And by George, is he milling these things. It is just effect after effect. This is just discount end phase warehouse. Let's go ahead and Galaxy Cyclone. Whatever this thing is. Compulse. It's actually kind of bad for us. I was hoping we wouldn't get compulsed. Because now... Fuck. Well, I can make him discard. I got 22. Let's see. The problem is he's got all these fours. So I'm not going to be able to do much. Let's see. This can blow up. That can do stuff. So we need to get rid of... These two are the two we need to get rid of. We can't let him keep Lumina. We can't let him keep Felice. And this guy... Wait, this guy can't blow up too. fuck. I think I may already be in a bit of a tricky pickle. Skill prisoner. That ain't gonna help you. Okay. That was a weird thing to activate. What's gonna make you discard stuff? Oh, and then he gets that. Okay. And Shadals. He's just got everything. Welp, I'm doomed. GG. I'll just mark this down as a loss right now, because I'm going to be taking the full brunt of stuff, and I will not be able to summon this guy. 12th duel, here we come. Alright, and here we are. 12th duel versus Smoke 6 style. I assume this is a 6 samurai deck, which is good, because I think we can handle 6 sams. Getting a bonus, just a free 1,000 life points. This is not 6 sams at all. This is some kind of DD deck. Shouldn't you be, like, Smoke DD style or something? DD Smoke style? Smoke? Something? I don't know. Of course, we start with our Necro Face, which is never good to start with. You always want to get that later on. But I think we've got a decent... I mean, we can get our... They make a lot of extra deck monsters. Hopefully they make one. We can get our, there we go. Fusion Summon. So we can make our Tierra. We really haven't gotten a lot of monsters that make extra decks. Or a lot of extra deck kind of decks. We've been doing, like, Lightsworns and stuff like that. Which is a real pity, because Tierra is really, like, the cornerstone of this deck. What's he got this? Make 4. Okay, he's just gonna give it back. Ah, he's got some kind of loop going on here with Lilith and all that. Cheese chase. Okay. Let's see. Well, we're gonna take our Frozen Void. Unless the MSTs it, in which case I'll be sad. But he didn't, so I'm not sad. We'll get rid of this. Give me my Void Dream. My Void Imagination. Imagination. I wish I had the editing skills to do that in the SpongeBob manner. Yay. Now I can make a big thing. It'll be a big thing, guys. It'll be really cool. Just watch it. Just come on. Why is it... Go. Let me go. I want to make things. Don't make me do stuff. Why am I waiting? What do you possibly got that you could stop? It already activated. He's got like a Wabaku or something weird like that. Connection lost! Ah, bullshit! I'll do a real 12th duel. Okay, here's the real 12th duel versus Junior. Oh, I can't believe it disconnected. That is nonsense. I was doing good, I could have done things. This is not as good of a hand. We don't got any of our spells. I'm just gonna make Tiara. We got Burial and this, which are redundant. You don't really want both of those. Although, I mean, I guess it's good. We can summon out like this and this and then do, and it's versus Cosmos. The one person you can't really stand to be like slow on. You gotta be super fast. Really just matters if he has stuff in his hand or not. No, actually, that kind of works. Unless he's got something that negates effects. Because even if he wants to banish and tag out, whatever he tags out for is going to get destroyed. Unless he has a Dark Destroyer, in which case I could suicide into it, put all my stuff back into the graveyard, and then just summon this out again. Yep. Chain Link 2. Summon a thing, then this will go off. Oh wait, no, he can banish that and summon something else. Fuck. He can just keep doing this. He can just dance this party. I forgot they do that when they're destroyed. For some reason, I always think that the ships are like the end-all be-all, but they are not. That's okay. Maybe he'll get another farm girl. Pretty sure you can only use one farm girl effect per turn. Nope. Oh wait, yeah, you can. So if he gets another farm girl, I can do this again and he won't be able to do that. And then I'll be set, like a jet. Otherwise, I'm fairly doomed. Let's just go ahead and do one of these. And then we'll just, let's see, we'll just special summon this again. And hope he has nothing in his hand. I could have summoned the other guy too, and then I'd have more resources and he wouldn't be able to do... Man, he's got all the Cosmo monsters in his hands. Another dank destroyer! Fuck! Cosmos, man. They're just floating all over the place. Just flim-flam floating all about. You start off with two dank destroyers in your hand. Nonsense. Poppycock. So there you go, there's the no-mill Infernoids. We went roughly 6-6. Pretty good. To be fair, like I said, this deck works a lot better. It runs on Tierra and it runs on Void Imagination, which they need an extra deck monster to do, and we didn't quite get the kind of decks that we needed to go against. We got the weird side of the meta, but you can see how this could be good. This has almost as much potential as the regular Infernoids. Maybe more so just because of its consistency. We'll see. Maybe someone out there can come up with a better build than mine. Either way, next week we'll be looking at something a little bit more current. Maybe the I don't know how to pronounce them. They're like zombie sword masters, guys. They're weird. You'll see. Until then, good luck. Have fun.